Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Today is the day to be in the presence of the Lord, to give him the thanks today, to give him the praise today, to give him the glory today, to shout out his holy name today, because we are victorious today, because we serve an awesome and amazing and faithful God who is moving mountains on our behalf right now today, who is still on the throne, who is still performing miracles and wonders right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to say this thank you today. I want to glorify you today. I just want to worship you today. I just want to let you know how much I'm in love with you today, that I trust you today, no matter what my situation looked like, no matter what my circumstances looked like. I want to give you the thanks today because you are worthy. You are worthy to be praised. And Jesus, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here right now today because of you, Jesus. I said because of you who gave us another day of life, because of you who gave us another chance at an opportunity, I want to say thank you today. I can't worry about what happened yesterday because yesterday is gone. I can't worry about what's going to happen tomorrow because tomorrow can't promise. Right now, today in your house, I want to say thank you. Right now in your house, I want to glorify you. Right now in your house, I want to give you the praise because you are deserving the praise and you are worthy to be praised each and every day because you who died on the cross, you who carried every last one of our sins, you did that for us so we can have an everlasting life for Jesus. I don't know about nobody else. If nobody else want to stand up and praise you, Minister LT is going to praise you. I'm going to worship you. I'm going to glorify you. I'm going to say I can't thank you enough each and every day because I can't thank you enough, Jesus. So that's why I praise you the way I do. Because of you, Jesus. Because of you, Jesus, I'm going to thank you. I'm going to praise you because you are worthy. You are worthy to be praised. So my sisters, my brothers, right now, give Jesus the praise in his house. Give him the glory right now in his house because he deserves it all. There's no limit to how many times you can praise him. But I want every last born worshiper, believer right now today, if Jesus is your everything and you know it's all about him and you know that he died on the cross for every last one of you and you know if he carried every last one of your sins, I want every last one of you right now today to stop doing what you're doing and give Jesus the praise and the glory right now in his house because he deserves it all. We serve an awesome and amazing and a faithful God. He is so amazing. He is so wonderful. He is so loving. He is so kind. He is so joyful. He is my everything. That's why I praise him. That's why I praise him with all my heart. I don't praise him because I want something. I don't praise him because I'm in need of anything. I praise him because I'm in love. I'm in love. I'm in love with Jesus. That's why I praise him. That's why I praise him. Amen. Amen. Glory, hallelujah. Amen. He is so wonderful. My brothers, my sisters, it is so, so beautiful to have y'all guys in my life and also my path. Minister LT can't thank y'all guys enough that y'all take y'all time out of y'all busy schedule to always listen to another word and another message that's coming from my Heavenly Father God. I just can't thank y'all enough for how faithful, how obedient that y'all are. Y'all could have been doing anything else, but y'all chose to watch Jesus' YouTube channel. Y'all chose to follow. Y'all chose to subscribe. Y'all chose to listen. And I just want to let you know how thankful I am, how grateful I am, how honored I am, how blessed I am that y'all guys are my life, that I'm in y'all life. I'm always going to continue to pray for every last one of y'all, knowing that God is doing some amazing and wonderful things in your life. I'm praying for healing for every last one of y'all, victory for every last one of y'all, prosperity for every last one of y'all, blessings, breakthrough, anointing, deliverance for every last one of you. God, I just ask you right now today to do something different. Every last one of my brothers and my sisters' life right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to guide them. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to direct them. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to comfort them. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to watch over them. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to speak a word in every last one of my brothers and my sisters' life right now today. My brothers and my sisters, according to the word of God, of Isaiah 43 verses 18 through 20, that Jesus is doing something new in every last one of y'all's life. And the reason why he is doing something new, because you are faithful, you are obedient, and you are faithful servant to him. That's why he is doing something new in every last one of y'all life right now today. Because of your faithfulness, because of your obedience, he is doing something new in every last one of y'all life. So right now, I want y'all to give Jesus the thanks right now. I want you to give him the praise right now. I want you to give him the glory right now for who he is and what he has done. Just thank him. Just praise him. Just worship him. Just glorify his holy name right now, my brothers and my sisters. Because if I'm happy and blessed, Jesus also is happy and blessed for every last one of y'all for what he is doing. He thank y'all for being faithful. He thank y'all for being obedient. He thank y'all for being faithful servants. Amen. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I am so glad to be a part of it and rejoice in it. He is worthy to be praised. Is there anyone out there in the world today that has not asked Jesus to come into their life? But today is the day that you have a made up mind that you say, you know what, I don't know where this is going. I don't know where I'll be at tomorrow, but right now I have to ask this question. Right now I want to be closer with God. Right now I'm encouraging right now today just to head to the altar right now. Or just to head in your room. Because I tell you what, my brothers and my sisters, right now it's not looking good for a lot of people right now. A lot of people right now is fighting for their life in a hospital. Right now they don't know if they have a chance anymore. They don't know if they have the opportunity anymore just to ask that question. But you do right now today. There's a lot of people right now don't even have a chance anymore, don't even have an opportunity anymore because they're dead and gone. My point is, my sisters, my point is, my brothers, nobody knows the time, the day, and the hour when something's going to happen. Tomorrow's not promised to nobody. Next week is not promised to nobody. Next month is not promised to nobody. Next year is not promised to nobody. Today is the day that you need to move forward. You need to make that happen right now today. Do not hesitate on this. Do not continue to put it off. Go ahead and move right now. Don't worry about what people might think or say about you or how somebody's feeling about you. If your mind is made up and you want to be close with God, all you got to do is say, Lord Jesus, today is the day that my mind is made up. My heart is alert. Right now, my heart is attentive. Right now, I'm asking you to be my Lord and Savior Christ. And once you boldly confess that, right then and there, you're saved. You're born again. You have just accepted the Holy Spirit in your life. I just want to say thank you, my brothers. Thank you, my sisters, because right now, you are saved in Christ right now. Welcome to the family. I see the families continue to grow because somebody's came home today. The angels are in heaven right now, rejoicing right now because somebody just boldly confessed. I just want to say thank you. My job is here not to continue to build a church or let a church grow because Jesus is the church. My job is so people can get to know who Jesus is so heaven continue to grow. Because Jesus is the church, no matter what. My job is so people can get to know who Jesus is and have a personal relationship with him, and so heaven can continue to grow and continue to expand. And I believe that somebody came home. Welcome to the family. Amen. Amen. My brothers, my sisters, y'all guys going to be in a treat today for today's word today because it's going to move somebody. And I know some people today probably been going through this, probably been scratching their head, probably ain't been wondering, like, what is it that I'm doing? I go to work or I'm around people, but it's like some people have a nasty attitude towards me. I know it's not coming off of me, so I'm speaking to them. I'm being polite. I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do. But why so many people feel like they have an attitude towards me? Why are they, when they see me, they put their head down, they turn their head around, or they'll see me and walk past me, won't speak to me, but they'll speak to somebody else. This word, this message is for you today. You need to stay tuned and you need to listen because this message is clearly for somebody today. Amen. Amen. Before I get started, I always like to take the time out to give our Heavenly Father God all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory. Oh, Heavenly Father God, I just can't thank you enough for an awesome and beautiful, blessed day today. I can't thank you enough for another day of life. I can't thank you enough for our strength. I can't thank you enough for our health. I can't thank you enough for the air that we was able to breathe. I can't thank you enough that I was able to get up and sing to you, to praise you, to glorify you, to get on my knees and pray, to open my Bible, to receive a word. I can't thank you enough for this message that we're about to receive today. I just can't thank you enough for your grace and your mercy. I can't thank you enough for your love. I just can't thank you for your forgiveness. I just can't thank you for the food that you put on that table, the clothes and shoe that you put on that back. I just can't thank you how you providing. I just can't thank you how you making the way. I just can't thank you for the open doors. I can't thank you for the door that you have closed. I can't thank you for our blessing. I can't thank you for our breakthrough. I can't thank you for our anointing. I can't thank you for our deliverance. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. 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 I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I glorify you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I shout out your holy name the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough. In Jesus' mighty holy name. Amen. Now, my sisters and brothers, we're about to get into this word. And I would love for y'all to turn your Bibles to John chapter 1, and we're going to read verse 5. That's John chapter 1, and we're going to read verse 5. And if you have your Bibles open and ready to receive this word today, let the church say amen. Amen. God bless you. Let's begin. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it yet. And you wonder why you think people got an attitude with you. They don't have an attitude with you. They just can't stand the light that's shining on you. That's why they're not talking to you. That's why they're walking with their head down. That's why they're walking past you, because you are glowing. You got the presence of the Lord on you. The Holy Spirit is shining through you. So anytime when you are going to work, or you at the gym, or you at the restaurant, or wherever you at, you notice people not talking to you, or people just walking past you, or you think somebody got a stank attitude towards you, it's not you, my sisters, my brothers. Them demons can't stand that light that's glowing. Then when they see it, they got an attitude towards the light. When they know it, they got an attitude towards what's inside of you. So that's why it's going on right now today. I don't know who I'm talking to right now today. I don't know who I'm preaching to right now today. But somebody have to know it. My sister, my brother, it's nothing that you're doing wrong. Only thing that you're doing is being in the presence of the Lord. That light is shining on you. And when that light is shining on you, a lot of people can't stand that glow. Because when you are glowing for the presence of the Lord, them demons cannot stand that light. And that's why a lot of people right now cannot understand you. That's why they'll never understand you. Because when you're in the presence of the Lord, when you've been faithful, when you've been obedient, and when you've been a faithful servant, that's why they are acting stank attitudes towards you. There's your answer right there. And I know some of you right now, you're going through it. You probably going through it at work. You probably say, okay, I talk to this person every day, but this person walked right past me. Every day, I say, hey, how you doing? I introduce myself, and what they do? They walk right past you. But as soon as they see somebody else, they talking. The reason why they talking to that person might not have that light and glowing like you're glowing. That's why they walk past you. It's nothing about you. The only thing about you that you're in the presence of the Lord. The only thing about you that you are glowing, that you are shining. So when other people see you, other people want to be attached to you. But them demons don't have no parts of you, my sisters. Them demons don't want no parts of you, my brothers. So that's why they always going to have their head down. That's why they always going to look at you funny. That's why they always not going to talk to you. That's why they always going to act the way they're going to act towards you. So right now, they may have an attitude. So you let them continue to have their attitude. You continue to shine. You continue to glow for the Lord. Don't you stop doing what you're doing, because they got things on them. Don't you stop doing what you're doing, because they got them dirty spirits on them. You keep doing exactly what God wants you to do. You keep continuing to be a faithful servant. You continue to be faithful and obedient, and you continue to seek him in this kingdom each and every day. You continue to praise him each and every day. You continue to worship him each and every day. Don't matter what, don't let nobody stop your glow, my sisters. Don't you let nobody stop your glow, my brothers. You continue to shine for the presence of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Because I tell you what, my sisters, my brothers, for a minute, I thought it was me. I thought I had done something wrong. Because I tell you what, I can go to work. And I just said that before I even started getting into the ministry. But once I started getting into it and really got deep into it, that's when it started bothering me a little bit. Because I said, man, I'm speaking to this supervisor. This supervisor looking right at me. But as soon as he see me, he put his head down. I say, hey, how you doing? Good morning. But he wouldn't say anything to me. But soon I take a couple steps up and he take a couple steps back. And it's a guy right here. He'll sit there and talk and chat with him like it wasn't nothing. I was like, something wrong with this picture. Now, I did sit there and spoke to him, but he didn't speak to me. But he sat there and took the time out to speak to him. So as time went on, I kept realizing. I was like, well, a lot of people sure don't like to talk to me. A lot of people, when they see me, they walk with their head down or they got their attitude towards me or something like something going on with them. So I'm thinking they probably having a bad day because, you know, as humans, we all going to have a bad day. But then I started realizing, I said, well, I know everybody don't have no bad day every day. Some days, yeah. But every day, the same time, Monday through Friday, that you got a bad attitude. Monday through Friday, every time you see me, you got your head down. Monday through Friday, every time you see me, you got an attitude. Then I started, no, I said, something wrong. I say something is wrong with this picture. And I don't know what it is. So I asked the Holy Spirit, I said, Holy Spirit, what is it? And it went right to the scripture right here. And turned right to John 1:5. The light shines in darkness. See, darkness can't shine in light, but the light can shine through the darkness. So when you walk in and that glow that's glowing like you and you just shine like you're a light bulb, that darkness cannot stand that light that's penetrating off you, my sisters, my brothers. So anytime you see somebody that's walking with their head down, they're walking past you, that's not speaking to you, don't want to spend time with you, don't want to be bothered with you, don't want to help you, just know one thing, that those darkness, those evil spirits on them cannot stand that light that's on you. That's what it could right now. Something you got a head or some headlights on you right now, and you are glowing and you are shining right now in the presence of the Lord. And some people love to be around you. Some people love to be attached to you. Some people that you don't even know, all they want to do is spend time with you. They can't wait to see you in the morning. They can't wait to see you get to work. They can't wait to see you when you go to the gym. They can't wait to see you when you go to the library. They can't wait to see you when you go to the grocery store. They can't wait to see you when you walk around in a parking lot on your mile walk. They just can't wait to see you. They can't wait to be a part of you. They can't wait to pick up the phone and call you and ask you what's going on, because that light that's attracted to you, some people draws to that light, my sisters. Some people draws to that light, my brothers. So that's why a lot of people are attracted to you. But the ones who have attitudes, the one who's acting foul, the ones who's acting stinking all the time, the one who walks around with their head down, the one who grumbling up on their breath every time they see you, because they got something on you, and what they have on them, they can't stand what you got on you. That's all what it is. They cannot stand that light. They can't stand that spirit. That's why you're going through what you're going through. So it ain't you, my sisters, my brothers, nothing that you have that's doing wrong. They have an attitude because you are shining. They have an attitude because you are glowing. They have an attitude because you're in the presence of the Lord. They have an attitude because you are obedient and you are a faithful servant. So that's why they have an attitude towards you. Amen. Amen. I don't know today who need to hear this word. I don't know today who need to hear this message, but I believe today that someone need to hear this. And you could have a family member going through it, or so-called you thought was your friend who's doing your way, and you wonder why it's going on, because that light that you have on. They still in the darkness, but you in the light. See, light can shine through darkness. Darkness can't shine through the light. So when you walk with that light on, what you think them demons doing? Oh, man, they go so-and-so. They go sister so-and-so. They go brother so-and-so. They don't want no part of you. They don't want no part of you. They don't want to hang with you. They don't want to talk with you. They don't want to dap with you. They don't want to hug with you. They don't want to talk to you. They don't want to associate with you. They don't want no parts of you because you have too much shine and going on with you. As long as you're in the presence of the Lord, a lot of people don't want to be part of their life. Especially they're still doing things in the world, and especially they're still doing things in the dark. They don't want no part of the light. Amen. Amen. And I hope that this word and I hope that this message today was clearly and helpful towards somebody today. And if it was today, I want you to give Jesus the thanks and the praise in his house right now today. Amen. Amen. Before I close, I always like to end with a prayer. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into my life to guide us, direct us, use us, so we can continue to build a relationship with you. And I believe right now in the mighty name of Jesus, by us praying this simple little prayer, that God is already working everything God in our life right now. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is withers.lt. Always keep Jesus first place. Always seek him, always honor him, always praise him. You continue to shine. You continue to glow. No matter if they got an attitude towards you or not, you continue to do what God wants you to do. You continue to be a faithful and obedient servant. No matter what, let them continue to have their stink attitude. Let them continue to have that nasty walk. Don't worry about them. Don't stoop to their level. You continue to glow, and you continue to shine for our presence of our Heavenly Father God. Amen. This is Minister LT. Y'all stay blessed. Y'all have a beautiful, blessed rest of the day. Amen.